The Schachter-Singer Theory of Emotion, also called the two-factor theory of emotion, states that emotion is based on two factors, physiological arousal and cognitive labeling. The two-factor theory was created by researchers Stanley Schachter and Jerome E. Singer, giving rise to the name Schachter-Singer Theory. The Schachter-Singer Theory is one of three major theories of emotion you should know for test day. So far in this series, we've already covered the James Lang and the Ken and Bard theories of emotion, so in this scene, I'll give you my visual mnemonic for the Schachter-Singer Theory, so you'll be sure to nail any questions about emotion on test day. Welcome to the set of Two Factor, America's hottest new singing show. What's so special about this series, you ask? Well, all the singing acts are duos of two singers, of course. No wonder why it's called Two Factor. By the way, the name of the show, Two Factor, helps anchor us to this scene on two-factor theory. Two-factor for two-factor theory. Get it? Also, don't forget that this is a singing show about, well, singers. Coincidentally, the singers here should help us remember the two-factor theory's other name, Schachter-Singer Theory. One of the psychologist guys who came up with this theory had the last name of Singer, and together, Schachter and Singer were quite the dynamic duo, just like the two people currently on stage. Just remember the singers here to peg the name, Schachter-Singer, to the two-factor theory of emotion. You know how singers in these competitions are super nervous? The people on stage at two-factor are no exception. Just look at the couple on stage. The competition is really getting to them. Their hearts are racing, and they're just covered in nervous sweat. You might even say that the external environment, that is, the competition, is eliciting a physiological response from them, consisting of a racing heart and nervous sweating. We can use this picture to help us remember the first portion of the Schachter-Singer theory, physiologic arousal. According to this theory, the first thing that happens in emotion is physiological arousal in response to environmental stimuli. Next, take a look at the judge judging the act. No wonder why this couple's so nervous. It looks like we have the world-famous Schachter Cowell judging the show. Just look at his contemplative look as he cognitively judges each performance. In the end, he labels each duet with a yes or no. You can think of our judge as cognitively appraising the performance, because cognitive appraisal is basically just a judgment, right? And from this judgment, we apply a label. This is a perfect parallel to the theory of emotion proposed by Schachter and Singer. After physiological arousal, we then cognitively appraise the physiological state and give it a label, just like our judge in the competition here. He's thinking hard about which label to put on the nervous act on stage. All right, it looks like somebody's already got a yes from the judges. Check out the celebrating guy out back and the broad smile on this guy's face. Yeah, just keep on smiling. You deserve it, buddy. By the way, his joyful expression of emotion will help us remember the final product of this process. Emotion. Yep. Schachter-Singer theory describes physiologic arousal, cognitive appraisal, and labeling, which sequentially produces the end product of emotion. In other words, the cognitive labeling is the emotion, and you can bet this guy is feeling very emotional after being labeled with the yes sticker. Let's offer a real-world example for completeness sake. Say you hear a scratching at the door, and you open the door to see a large growling pit bull. In response, your heart starts racing and you start sweating. However, a racing heart and sweating can happen in other contexts, right? Think about the joy you get at a concert or maybe after winning a soccer game. In both of these contexts, you can have the same physiologic response of a racing heart and sweating, but they correspond to completely different emotions. So how do you know that in front of this growling dog, your racing heart is actually fear? And not something like exhilaration or excitement? Well, the answer is cognitive labeling. Your brain searched your environment for cues that help it decide why the physiological arousal is happening. When it sees the pit bull, your brain labels the situation as something that should cause fear. In short, this cognitive labeling is responsible for experiencing the correct emotion. Note that cognitive labeling is the primary difference in the Schachter-Singer theory as compared to the James Lang theory. While James Lang theory holds that physiological arousal alone produces emotion, Schachter-Singer says that you need a second factor, cognitive labeling. Got that? All right, enough singing. Let's recap real quick so we can catch the next leg of two-factor in Vegas. The Schachter-Singer Theory, also known as the two-factor theory of emotion, states that two steps are needed to experience emotion. First, environmental stimuli elicits a physiological response. Second, we cognitively appraise this physiological activity and try to give it the correct label. Emotions are produced as a result of this cognitive labeling. And that's it for this episode of Two Factor. Next up, America's most boring home videos with 2 full hours of paint drying. I'll catch you in next week's episode.
Thanks for watching. For more videos like this one, click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also support our team by visiting pixelrise.com, where you'll find exclusive videos and interactive review images. If you like what we're doing, share with your friends on social media, and we'll keep making great content like this. We'll see you next time.